My dear friends, today the parable speaks about two people. One is a Pharisee and a tax collector. They both go to the temple to pray. But then the tax collector stays in the back and he bowed his head, beating his chest. He said, "Lord, I'm a sinner. Have mercy on me." See the beauty of that prayer. He says that I have done so many wrong things, that I am broken, that I have made blunders, mistakes in my life. In a way, his pride is crushed. Tax collectors are wealthy people, well-to-do people. They were in the good books of Roman Empire. But then this person is broken, broken with sin. It's beautiful when you are broken. With sin you can hide. If you want to stay safe, you can hide yourself. But then if you're broken, Lord will accept a broken heart. So he sometimes allows you to break. Allow Satan in your life. First reading, little bit earlier, the passage before this, Hosea chapter 5 verse 15, it is said, Lord is saying, I will leave my people and go to my chamber and close my door. So when they suffer, sometimes they would come in search of me. So God has left them with a purpose. Sin sometimes is the reason for your pain, your downfall, your calamity. It's a blessing though. Because of that pain, you take that turn. You turn. Today it's said, come let us return to Yahweh. He who shattered us to pieces will heal us as well. He has struck us down, but he will bind up our wounds. See this paradox. He will shatter us, scatter us, he will heal us. He will wound us, he will bind us. Though both the things happen in love. If you are going away, you should suffer. In that suffering, God is there. When you come back, you will enjoy that bosom. Enjoy that company. Because God is there. Your sensitivity is a blessing. If you are sensitive, this is wrong, and you go towards struggle, it's beautiful. Because it will break your heart. With the broken heart, it's easy to deal with the Lord. God finds very easy to mend a broken heart, to use a broken person. That's exactly why the particular Pharisee, he went in front of the altar and said, see the prayer, said, I thank you, God, that I am not like other people, grasping, crooked, adulterous, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give me tenth of all my income to the temple. It's all lot of I's and my's, you know. Ego. When you hide your pride, when you hide your weakness, you're blinded by it with your pride. So what would happen? You're lost. God will never accept you. God does not want your boasting. For what? Why God is empty or what? No, he doesn't want it. He will crush your pride. The beautiful example, my dear friends. Beautiful example. The Pharisee, St. Paul. Saul earlier was a Pharisee. He's a student of Gamaliel. And a studious person, well-educated Pharisee. And God made him fall from the horseback. crushed him to the ground and made him eat the dust of the earth. And he was put to zero. He was broken and he was blinded with a light. See the contradiction. And then God made him not Saul, but Paul. Saul became Paul with a fall. My dear friends, Paul means tiny. That swollen-headed, inflated-minded person is crushed to Paul, which is tiny. This is exactly what should happen to us. So if you are broken, be happy. If you are hurt, be happy. If you are crushed, be happy. Because definitely, if you are broken, if you hide your brokenness, end of the story. But if you deal your brokenness with God, it is said 2 days later, he will bring us back to life. On the third day, he will raise us up, and we shall live in his presence. Let us strive to know Yahweh. His coming is as certain as the dawn. His judgment will burst forth like the light. He will come to us as showers come like spring, rain that waters the earth. Beautiful. So in your lost brokenness, his love is at hand. His love is waiting. Just deal your brokenness with him. Don't throw pearls to swine, pigs. They will crush them, stamp over them and crush them. So throw your brokenness. Only God knows what to do with your broken pieces, because he's a creator. He's a creator and he's a painter and the artist who knows exactly what to do with your broken parts. So be happy if you're broken. If you're still swollen with your pride, blinded with your pride, ego, just ask him to break and take. Because in brokenness, you will enjoy the love of God in a strong way. And his love is certain. Wait in your pain. Definitely, he will come like the dawn, like the rain to your life, my dear friends. Amen. May God bless you.